one crazy story when I was on tour with EPMD, and what you got to understand is that, you know, touring in the 80s was a different time from the 90s, the early 2000s to now, because we didn't know what was going on in each other's hoods. Like, people didn't know what was going on in LA and in Little Rock, Arkansas, you know, so on and so forth, like Chicago. So we was in Chicago one day doing a live on remote visit. So we was at a White Castle. You know, the radio station van is there, like, yeah, we got EPMD and DJ Scratch here. We on the corner of whatever, whatever. You know, and back then I used to rock, like, the military hats, and I used to rock it to the side like this. So I'm standing outside. I didn't even see the dude come up on me. But just out of nowhere, somebody just popped up. He was right on my neck. Like, he was like, yo, homie, you're a homie. I know you're not from here. He said, but yo, I just need you to do one thing. Turn your hat straight to the front or straight to the back. I took the hat off and threw it in the garbage. You know, and then later on, he told me what the deal was. One side meant one game, one meant the other. So, you know, just traveling, you know, early in the 80s, we would see different, you know, different gangs and street codes in different cities that was different from Brooklyn. But, you know, we never really understood that, because in Brooklyn, in New York, you're getting beef or get shot just for looking at somebody more than 3 seconds, the 3 second look. Like, so if you glance at somebody, you know, but if you look again, it's like, yo, what the fuck you looking at, you know? And then it's on. So we didn't understand any of this, any of that, because all it takes is a look for somebody to die in New York. And we didn't understand the colors, the red and blue. So when we got to LA, we found out the same thing.